The Hawaiian island chain, especially the Big Island of Hawaii, is well known for containing numerous active and extinct shield volcanoes. This type of volcano is very large with a negligible incline due to the lavas they produce flowing far from their summit due to having a low viscosity. At the Kilauea volcano, several secondary shield volcano vents have been constructed in recent years along the east rift zone, such as Mauna Ulu, which erupted between 1969 and 1974, and Pu'u'o'o, which erupted between 1983 and 2018. Thus, because of their fairly recognizable profile, you might think that this feature being shown on screen is also a shield volcano. After all, it has gentle slopes, an active vent in its center, and emits numerous flows of lava. However, this vent is instead a sort of geologic oddity, as it is not a secondary shield volcano, being rather referred to as a sort of fake shield volcano known as a rootless shield. So-called rootless shields can be quite large, measuring up to 1,640 feet or 500 meters wide and up to 130 feet or 40 meters tall. However, despite their size, they are still merely a fraction of the height or width of the world's smallest shield volcanoes, as shown by this diagram comparing the Devil Mountain Shield Volcano in Alaska and the largest known rootless shield feature. What makes rootless shields even weirder is the fact that they do not exist right over a vent being directly supplied from the subsurface. Rather, these features form due to turbulence in a lava tube. For context, lava tubes are sort of concealed rivers of lava which during volcanic eruptions supply molten rock to more distant locations, often occurring underneath the top of major lava flows. These lava tubes can be incredibly long, sometimes more than 10 miles in length, and I even saw one in action as some lava at the top of the flow during the 2022 eruption of Fagradalsfjall in Iceland drained into a tube. These lava tubes, such as those formed during many Hawaiian eruptions, often have varying widths and heights in different sections of a single tube. Thus, in some sections of a lava tube, the supply of lava into one section might be higher than the amount which can drain 2 meters in front of it. Due to this imbalance, lava within the tube will often start expanding towards a path of least resistance, which could be horizontally or vertically. It all depends on which direction is covered by the least amount of lava. If this least resistance path is upwards, lava begins flowing upwards. This then flows onto the surface, often forming a small lava fountain or insignificant dome fountain which erupts molten material despite not being directly connected to the subsurface. This process deposits various layers of lava which, over time, build a shield-like feature that can be more than 1,000 feet wide and 100 feet tall. These rootless shields can be active on the order of several days to several years. Oftentimes, these features are difficult to spot unless they are fairly large, although many are often topped by a small lava pond such as shown in this photo. While these rootless shields can form at many volcanoes around the planet, a high number of them, more than a dozen in fact, have been documented during Kilauea's eruptions in the last 50 years, such as during 2002, 2008, and 2010. As a final note, just like littoral cones, rootless shields can be tough to spot, but their generally small size when compared to their larger counterparts make them somewhat easy to notice. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.